Well, there was a harmonica sound that was taking shape in Chicago in the early 1950s, and Little Walter, the great virtuoso of blues harmonica, was certainly the most important player to come out of that scene. And Little Walter played what's called crossharp. It's the harmonica sound that you usually hear. Kind of played on the bottom of the harmonica. Jimmy recorded early in his career with John and Grace Brim. They were a blues duo, and he played harmonica on one of their records, sounding a little bit like Little Walter, an amplified harmonica sound. But somewhere along the way, he got the idea that he would play guitar and harmonica at the same time, simultaneously. Now, he wasn't a great guitar player. He certainly held down the bottom on his songs, but he decided he would make a harmonica holder out of a coat hanger. And he started playing what you would call first position harmonica, playing the high notes at the top end of the harmonica, which you can also slur and bend, and that became his trademark sound. When you hear that, I mean, you know that's Jimmy Reed. The idea of playing harmonica in a rack like that, it was Jimmy Reed, I think, that probably planted the seed in the minds of people like Bob Dylan and Neil Young, who became rack harmonica players. And he was just a master of it. He had very good control of his pitch and the bends and where he was going. Again, it was just as lazy as his voice, but it's a very appealing sound.
Feels so bad, baby.